you trying to do?
EA Sports coverage of the NFL brings us to the Sunshine State and TIAA Bank Field here in Jacksonville. Nothing like the fanfare of introductions to an NFL game, and that was in evidence a moment ago. Fireworks, pyrotechnics, you name it, this crowd is ready as their guys get set to match up between the Indianapolis Colts and the Jacksonville Jaguars. Taken in the end zone. And this will go as a touchback, and they will begin things at the 25. Former Badger Jonathan Taylor. So on the big tight end, holding.
Each and every year, we talk about very few tight ends coming into the league that are polished blockers or asked to do it a lot in college. So it's a constant struggle and a constant fight to learn how to do it without holding.
So following the hold, they're in a bit of a hole here with a first and 20. The give to Taylor. And he'll take this across the 25 before going out of bounds. Call it a gain of 12, but of course not a first down due to the previous penalty.
Partner, I remember a coaching friend of mine used to tell his running backs before games, make sure you run and jog with your offensive line in pregame. Get used to the ground shaking when those big behemoths start to create space for you up front. He did a pretty good job of just following those guys through there for a nice explosive run.
On second down, it's Taylor. And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. He'll wind up losing three. And now it's third down.
Nice play right there to stop him behind the line. But I want to see how this defense continues to play him here in the first half.
Yeah, we know. You know better than I. He has the ability to take over a game. So what do you do?
Yeah, I think you have to make sure that you bottle him in at varying levels. Because if you crowd everyone to the line of scrimmage, if he breaks through, it's nothing but room to run.
Oh, Foster staying down after that last play. Let's hope he's okay. Well, he gets attended to. We'll step aside. First and 10, Taylor now. And not able to break away this time as they're going to stop him right around the line of scrimmage. 2 yards the loss, second and 12.
This defense is a difficult one to prepare for, one of the best in the league. They'll come at you from all angles, and they did a nice job there stopping him for a loss.
Second and 12, Prescott. He'll find Paris Campbell. That's complete. And he's going to have another first down as the tackle's made at the Jaguars' 45-yard line. Another good reception there. The Colts on the march. Indianapolis. So in Jacksonville territory now, here's a first and 10 at the 45-yard line. They give to Taylor out of the gun. And able to push forward for right around 3 yards down to the 42.
Well, that's just a pile of bodies there, and that's when you kind of find out who's a tough guy, right? Who can stand up and make a play? It was only a 3-yard run, but for both sides, they had to walk away from that feeling like, okay, I can stand up when the going gets tough in here.
On second and 7, Prescott. Under pressure, and he will go down. Sacked back at the 46. Josh Allen in there to get him, and that is sack number 6 now for him on the year. The 7th play now in this opening drive. This is 3rd and long, though. Play fake, Prescott. He'll let it go deep for Foster. And unable to connect. Incomplete. Well, give them credit. They took their shot, but it's going to bring up fourth down.
Brandon, we saw these defenders flying to the football in their win last week, and nothing has changed. They're still moving around quickly and forcing incompletions.
On fourth down, punt coming from Braden Mann. He punted five times in the win last week as this one's away. And that hits at the six and carries into the end zone for a touchback.
At their own 20-yard line.
They'll run on first down. It's Rose, and he is brought down at the 22 after a gain of two, and it brings up second down.
2 yards on the pick.
Certainly a nice job there by the defense rallying to the football and getting him on the ground, but I think the play gets made by the defensive front because if they can't get upfield, their job is to go ahead and get low, almost get into a ball sometimes, stack things up, and make it difficult for the runner to find a hole.
From the 22, here's second and eight. To throw it is Locke. He finds Corey Davis. And they're able to get this one across the 35. 50 catches for him now on the year, and he's got a first down.
I don't care who you put on him, he's going to be a handful in one-on-one throws.
Yeah, right now, you're right. They're in man-to-man, maybe need some safety help.
I would say that'd be a good idea. Double-team him somehow. I'm going to have to make someone else beat me rather than let him shred my defense.
So from the 36 now, first and 10. Play action. Now it's Locke. He'll get this one complete to Davis. He's got this to the 30 before being taken down. A big play on the catch and run covering 34 yards.
We know play callers can be very creative in this game today, but sometimes when they've got receivers with speed like this, they don't need to design incredibly complex calls. Sometimes it's just get the ball in his hands and let him do his thing. In a sense, less can become more, and it was right there.
Bobby Okereke.
Oh, that's a real nice job there by the defense in front. They just engaged and held their ground. But how about the guy who made the play? We often talk about whether they take a good first step or not. Many times you just don't take any step. Just get your feet moving, get your body going, and then once he made the read, he was able to make the play.
And only able to muster a couple down to about the 27. And now we'll get a timeout. Looks like we've got a Jaguar in some discomfort down there on the field. While the training staff takes a peek, we'll take a break. They got to get to the 20 to keep the drive alive on third down. Locke working out of the gun. And he's got a man, Corey Davis. And he is going to have a Jags first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. 16 yards that time on the pickup for the Jags and a first down. With it, and that's in the area of a face mask, I think. So the face mask moves him closer, and now first and goal. They'll look to run with Singletary, and he'll take this one in for a Jags touchdown. Devin Singletary, his fifth touchdown now on the year. And the Jags have taken the early lead. And this is up and good. The score now 7-0 Jaguars.
Makes the score Jaguars 7, Colts nothing.
Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. Fielded near the back of the end zone. And he'll just take a seat, and the drive will begin at the 25-yard line.
25-yard line.
The Colts come to the line ready to start their next drive and hoping to do better than they did their last possession when they punted the football.
Appeal to the vanity of your offensive line. Tell them that they control your fate. Leverage guys. Win the line of scrimmage. If you do that, you start to win first down. You win second down. And guess what? You start accumulating first downs. And that's what they need in order to not punt the ball again.
It's now second and six at the 29-yard line.
Second and six, just inside the 30. They'll run the toss here with Taylor. He finds an opening past the 40. And he will finally be taken out of bounds as it's an enormous play there on the final snap of this first quarter. After one, 7-0 on EA Sports.
Jaguars 7, Colts nothing.
So in Jacksonville territory now, here's a first and 10 at the 25-yard line. From the gun, it's Taylor. And that'll hurt the average a bit as this time they're able to get him behind the line. Different story this time around. We had that huge gain followed by a sizable loss here. They'll try to throw now. Prescott flushed out right. And that'll be incomplete. Took a pretty good shot as he tried to pull that one in. Couldn't hang on, third down.
That was an interesting look there because as soon as he got outside the pocket, I thought he was going to take off and run for yardage. But what often happens now with these quarterbacks who can move, defenses want to try and keep bodies in front of them. And I think that discouraged him from taking off and made him try a pass downfield that fell incomplete.
And he's going to have the connection to Foster. And he's going to get this to about the 20, but that is well short of what he needed. It'll be a gain of 8, but it'll also lead to a fourth down. The kick by Carlson is good. And they are on the board, but still trailing. It's 7-3. So a good kick there. They put the bow tie on it with 3 points.
And let's face it, everybody wants a touchdown. We know that. But in the NFL, defenses are awfully good. You're not going to score each and every time. Be able to knock the ball through the post and take the three.
By the way, I said bow tie. I meant just bow.
Either way.
Not the tie, but yeah.
Either way.
You got it.
I just went right past it.
Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. And you know, it's certainly a lot of football left to play. We're not into December yet, but right now where we stand, they're in first place in their division, looking really good and looking to be a threat come January.
And are you one of those early holiday shoppers, partner? Are you one of those guys, get your list done? Because I think about what every team has on their holiday shopping list right now. What's the number one goal? Make the playoffs. Number two, win your division. Number three, and I think the biggest goal of all, try to get the number one seed so you get that first round bye and ensure you don't have to go anywhere in January and hopefully get to the Super Bowl that way.
From the 27, Locke. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete.
And I think they'd be well served to take that type of a physical approach against him the rest of the game. He's had his way so far, but on that last one, that worked quite well for the defense.
So the failure to connect on second down, that leaves them staring up here at a third and 8.
Watch a flat. You got tight right there.
See it. Kill.
Go.
Now Locke. Eluding the pressure right. On the run, he'll let this go deep right side. And it's knocked away and incomplete.
And this is what you want to see from a defense. Give up an opening drive touchdown, that's fine. But how about them going back out there, recommitting themselves to the task at hand, and forcing a three and out and giving the ball back to their offense.
He'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds. A great return there of 22 yards. And the Colts are set up well as they take over first and 10 on the short side of the field. Play action now, Prescott. And that'll be incomplete. We do have a penalty flag down, however. Let's see what that's about. They lose the yardage, and of course, they also lose the down on the grounding call, and it's quickly second and long. On play action, Prescott. Man open, that's Calvin Ridley. And the stop here will come at the 38-yard line.
A big gain on the play, but it's third down.
The Colts on third down, just 1 for 3 thus far. They're looking at third in the nose of the football. They'll try and run for the first with Taylor. And he's taken down inside the 30. Another nice gain. That's now 30 yards between those last two plays.
I like the look that they just showed there. When you come out in a passing formation, spread things out a little bit, makes it really hard to cover the middle of the field, doesn't it? Because you've got to go out to the perimeter and cover those guys.
Yep, exactly. Got some good blocking, too. Helped him pick up the first. And he'll get about 4 as he's brought down at the 24.
End result of that one, a nice 4-yard gain. So you can use that to set up your play action game, or you can come right back and continue to run the football, because as an offensive play caller, you're on schedule and feeling pretty good about your next couple of calls.
And he is out of bounds, looks like right at the 15.
We use the word relentless a lot with guys who are aggressive on the field. In this case, it really fits, doesn't it? How about his ability to break tackles and his feet never stop moving?
From the red zone now, Prescott. He gets this into the hands of Taylor. And he's able to work it here to the 8-yard line. Give him 6 on the play, and that'll make this a second down.
Second and 4 at the 8-yard line.
Here's Taylor. And he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there. Call it no gain that time, as it's going to leave him with a 3rd and about 3 to go.
And it's 3rd down.
Two minutes to play in this first half. 7-3, our score. A reminder coming up just a few minutes from now, we'll send you to Jonathan Coachman and our crew in Orlando. Coach will have a look back at some of the stats and scores from yesterday's action. Third and short yardage, Prescott. They'll try and set up the screen to Hines. And they go the wrong way on this one. Losing yardage back at the 12.
That's a nice clip and save sequence there defensively, because they did everything as they would have wanted to. They forced a third down. Blanketed the field with coverage, nowhere to go with the football. Forced a dump off to the back, and even then, they closed quickly and got him down behind the line of scrimmage. You name it, they did it well in that last sequence.
So we're back to a 1-point game now as the kickoff comes. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback.
5-yard line.
Set,
The Jacksonville offense set to begin their next drive. They're out in front. Last time they had to punt it away. We'll see if they can add to their lead now.
They don't want to go out and punt it away again. This team now wants to get a cushion, put people away. They want to run their offense and have it end up in the end zone.
Successful start to the drive, 17 yards. It moves the sticks. One play has him up past the 40 already, and another first and 10. That throw into the arms of Allen. No gain there on the completion, second and 10.
Well, that was a simple throw and catch, but even with that completion, 0 yards gained, so they're behind schedule on down and distance.
I think they were hoping to get it to him. He could make a man or two miss, but that window closed quickly. 8 yards on the completion, but now they face third down.
You can see the time and effort and thought that they put into their passing game because it was evident right there. It looks like a simple pitch and catch, but you and I both know that they have planned for this and worked hard to make it happen.
Third and two, Locke's going to throw. Throwing the out route and complete. It's Mills.
When an offense reads blitz, doesn't matter where it's coming from, tight ends know that they become a big part of the passing game because they should be an easy outlet when all those extra bodies are trying to get to the quarterback. A hot route, so to speak.
Lock now on first down. And this will be incomplete. Physical play on the football there, and it's second down.
It went with a dime look on defense. Two extra defensive backs on the field and covered up essentially every blade of grass. That allowed them to disrupt the play.
After the incomplete pass, here now is second and 10. Throwing again, Lock, and that is incomplete. A lot of force bearing down on him there. He could not hang on. It's third down.
That one was all about the defender making life difficult for the receiver. Very tough for a guy to hold on to the football through all that contact. He ends up forcing the incompletion.
Now they face a third and 10 after back-to-back incompletions. On play action, Lock. That's incomplete, but there is a flag down. So hang on, a big call coming on third down. Now, if you're going to get rid of it, you better get outside the pocket.
Yeah, you have to get outside of that tackle-to-tackle box, right? Get out there, and then you can do it legally. But he wasn't able to do so, and they end up losing the down as well.
Fielded at the 20. And he takes us beyond the 35 before going out of bounds. A very good return that time. 18 yards. And control of the football, switching hands with very little time remaining until the half. The Colts going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll stop it with 17 seconds to go in this first half of action. So good starting field position for them here as they come up first and 10 at their 38. Out of the gun, here's Prescott. Jaguar pressure and a Jaguar sack. Now the Jags will use the second of their timeouts as they'll stop it with 13 seconds to play in half number one. And the job becomes twice as difficult now after the sack. It's second and 20. Another try after the first down sack. Prescott airing it out, looking for Ridley. Into a double team, and it's intercepted. Picked off around the 27.
Intercepted. The Jaguars take over first and 10 at their own 26-yard line.
Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. And from this spot in the field with the clock where it's at, you think we're just going to see a knee and that's it?
And I think in this situation, that's the proper play. But we do know there's some risk takers out there that may want to take one more shot before the clock runs out.
Brings up second and 9.
Here's second and 9, just a yard on that last run.
Watch tight end, watch tight end. Tight right, kill, 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 turn it. Check.
A final shot before half for Locke. And a flag comes in as that one falls incomplete. Well, let's see who this is on. So we're at halftime with our score 7-6 in a tough-fought first half. As we send you a couple hours south of here to Orlando, that's where we check in with a coach and our EA Sports Halftime Report. The Jaguars in possession of the lead, and they will get the football as we are underway in the second half. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. Play action. Got his man complete over the middle. That's Mills. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. The drive starting with a first down, 11 yards on that pickup. Now a play fake, and here's Locke. This one caught by Davis. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. It's a first down, his fourth catch of the game after having three in the first half.
46-yard line.
First down, Rhodes. And he's going to take this one across midfield and into Colts territory. It's a 6-yard gain on the ground, and that'll make it second and four.
That's a really nice job by them picking up the run blitz and detecting it and blocking it and turning it into a nice run. And a lot of times you think if you blitz a running play, you're going to smother it. But a lot of the blitzers, they come in a little bit high. They don't have great leverage, and they're easily blocked and turned to the side.
And they'll get this just to the 47. 1 yard gain.
Caught that look from you there, partner. I think we're on the same page on that one. Just his first catch. I think we both thought he'd be a little more active in the passing game. Let's see if that's the start of them trying to get the ball to him a little bit more here in the second half.
Locke going to try and throw on third down. Looking for his running back, and he's got him. And they'll get him to the ground. He has another first down at the Colts' 25-yard line. Well, they were in search of a short gain on third down, and they wind up nabbing over 20 yards. They'll run on first down. It's Rose. And not much of a hole there as he gets it down to about the 24-yard line. And now we'll get a timeout. Looks like we've got a Jaguar in some discomfort down there on the field. While the training staff works on him, we'll step aside and be right back. The run only got a yard. Here's second and nine. On the ground, it's Singletary. Two runs in a row, but only 2 yards to show for it.
Watching that play unfold and watching him complete it brought back memories of doing all those pursuit drills to make sure you don't over-pursue and let a guy get a cutback lane on you. He did that very well.
You praised him on tape yesterday for the angles that he takes to the ball. Took a great angle right there. Throwing his lock on third down. And a throw there going to be incomplete. We saw this a lot in the first half, and it continues. These receivers just not able to get much separation.
So that means they have to win the 50-50 balls. They've got to go up with the defender and find a way to start coming down with them.
And this time, contact and another incomplete pass. A field goal would tie it, but they want more. They're going for it. They'll go for it. It's Locke. And able to get him down, but he does reach the five. He was held without a catch in the first half, but he's got one here, and he also picks up a first down. Locke going to throw. And the Jags are going to be set up with a first and goal. He couldn't quite reach the chalk, but they'll have it at the 1 yard line. A pickup of four on first down. It'll be second and goal. Second and goal from the one. They'll try to run this one in. And he takes it in. Touchdown, Jacksonville. A great play there. His first touchdown on the year. And the Jaguars add on to their lead. So the Jags will keep the offense out there as they'll decide to go for two. They fake the handoff. Now Lock. And oh, it'll be intercepted. Good positioning, and it's picked off. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
13, Colts 6.
The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. He takes this near the 25, just a little pass there, call it the 26.
At their own 26-yard line.
The Colts come to the line ready to start their next drive. They trail offense, first time to touch the ball in quarter three, and we'll see what they can do.
And I can't wait to see what they have planned, because some teams script to start a half. Other teams just go, okay, these are the sequence of plays we want to run. These things worked well for us. And sometimes they throw in that big chunk play right away.
Shocker.
Try and get after them early and try and create a big play to give themselves some momentum.
See what they have up their sleeve.
7-yard line.
Still 9 yards to go on second down from the 27. From the shotgun, it's Prescott. He's going to take off with it. A nifty bit of scrambling there. 12 yards, first down. Last drive, remember, similar situation. He forced a ball into coverage through the pick. He learned better there.
Yeah, similar to a golfer that's confronted with a shot that you just can't make. Sometimes you have to take your medicine, as they say, right? Just pull it down, take off, and go. Don't make something worse than what it was.
They'll lose a yard there, and it's second and 11. You know, despite the scoreline, I think they've got to like where they are here. They're on the road in just one big play away from getting right back in this game.
I'm gonna follow right along with you, because the spot they're in now is a credit to their defense. They've kept them in it by making the plays that they've made, and that just means you're one big score away from being right back there.
Now the question is, can this offense step up and make that play, because that's been an issue for them in this game. An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. He may try and run for this. A nifty bit of scrambling there. 12 yards, first down.
Containing him is becoming a big problem. We've already seen this once earlier on this drive.
Yeah, and so now two times this has happened. Do you adjust something?
Yeah, I think you do. I think you gotta start thinking about your rush lanes. Try not to either get too wide or too narrow. Make sure someone is there waiting for him to take off.
And he's going to get this one down to the 45.
The ball carrier.
5 yards on the carry. Good pickup on first down.
Nice satisfying run on first down for the offense, picking up five, which means defensively, the thought process is entirely different. You don't want to panic, but at the same time, you're saying to each other, we've got to tighten this down. We can't give up gains like that.
Escaping the pressure right. Oh, a ball batted in the air, and now it's intercepted. Picked off near the 34.
The Jaguars take over first and 10.
The Jacksonville offense set to begin their next drive. On first down, Rose. And he'll get two, maybe three, up near the 37.
Number two, the tackle made by Derek Barnett.
One quarter remains here as we wrap up the week on a Monday night. This is the National Football League on EA Sports.
Colts 6.
3 yards on that last carry. Here's second and 7. Off play action. Lock. Throw left side complete. That's Rose. And a 6-yard gain gets him right around the 43. A gain of 3 last play. This time they double it and pick up 6.
Another nice pickup through the air. And I think a lot of people might expect them to run the ball in this situation, Brandon. But with this lead, they're electing to throw the football. Swings, slants, quick outs, things that they consider safe.
The Jaguars on third down. They've converted 3 out of 5 thus far. They need just a yard here. It's 3rd and 1. And he'll give it here to his running back. And boy, he is very close to a first down, but from where they're spotting that football, he's going to be a foot or so short. Just a yard on the run there, and that's going to bring us to a 4th down. The offense offense here not budging. They're going to fight for it on fourth and inches. They'll try and run for it. And this will depend on the mark. I'm not sure he pushed the line forward. And indeed, he did not. They stop him. So that's a decision that could loom pretty large here. They go for it on fourth down, but come up empty.
But I actually like the call, and the reason, it shows me a head coach has faith in his team overall. First on the offensive side, thinking they can pick it up, but also knowing that he has faith in his defense that if they don't, they'll go out there and stop him. I like the confidence he showed.
The last run got three. Now here's second and seven. They go to the ground again with Taylor. And he is close to a first down as he's tackled at the Jaguars 34. It'll go as a gain of seven on the play, and it sets up a third and inches situation.
Brings up third and inches.
Find Hines out of the backfield. And he is going to have a Colts first down as he's able to get about three that time on third and inches.
First down, Colts.
Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10. Now Taylor. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. Indianapolis moving the chains there on a gain of 12.
Oh, that's one to warm the hearts of all those old school football players, isn't it? Tough, hard, gritty run. Got behind his pads, bowled over a few people. Look at that one, right up the gut.
Saw it through three quarters, no reason to lighten up. And he'll get into the end zone. Touchdown, Indianapolis.
Touchdown.
Jonathan Taylor. With touchdown number 29, two short of LaDainian Tomlinson's all-time record 31. And the Colts are an extra point away from tying up this football game. Don't forget the extra point. It's up and good. And, partner, we've got a tie game here in the fourth. All square now at 13-all as he sends this one away. And this will make it into the end zone. And beyond the 20, but not by much. In fact, just a yard pass there to the 21.
Their own 22-yard line.
Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. Well, they just gave up the score to tie it. That's the bad news. The good news, plenty of time in this fourth quarter to try to grab that lead back. Now this one complete to Corey Davis. And he's tackled a yard short of the marker. Good gain of nine on first down.
I always laugh when people say, what's the toughest route to defend? And I'm like, any of them, especially if it's a good receiver. That makes things very difficult. But when you're running a drag route, something short and shallow, going through defenders, using guys almost as screens in order to get open, that makes things tougher, guys trying to get to the football.
Here we go, third and one. Gut check time on both sides. From the gun, it's Locke. And a quick throw here, that's complete. And he will have a Jaguars first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. Defense was expecting run, and they're dealt a pass of over 15 yards. A great Monday night to wrap up the week in football. Two division rivals and a great finish ahead as we come up on first and 10. And he'll lose yardage here, back at the 47. 2 yards the loss, second and 12.
It's a loss of two. Brings up second and 12.
Play action. Now it's Locke. Over the middle, complete. It's Mills. And they'll get him down as he's inside the 40. 16 yards, a first down. They're making steady progress, but I see your face. You're worried about that clock.
I'm worried about the clock, and at some point, you have to have a splash play in there as well.
Some pretty good games all weekend. We may have saved the best for last. This Monday night game has been a dandy. They'll run on first down. It's Rose. And this time they were ready for him as they'll stop him right at the line of scrimmage. There to stop him was Darius Leonard. Officially nothing on that last run. They'll try again second and 10.
Partner, you've got about 20 coaches on your payroll, but there's 60,000 of them in the stands. I don't think any of them like that play.
And the later we go, it's starting to sound like 100,000 in here. The second down play, not much better than the first. Just a gain of one there.
Brings up third down and 9.
And we will get a timeout with 2 ticks left. So now this one's going to rest on the foot of their second-year kicker. And we will get a timeout with 2 ticks left. So now this one's going to rest on the foot of their second-year kicker. This a long one from 54. And that will line up just short. He had it online. It ran out of gas at the end. And here in overtime, if the team that receives the ball scores a touchdown, it's over. If they don't, we can still have some more football.
That's exactly right. If they go down and kick a field goal, the other team gets a possession to either match it or score a touchdown to win the ball game. If both teams kick field goals, the next team to score wins. But if the receiving team throws a pick six or fumbles the ball and it gets picked up by the defense and they score, the game is over at that point.
That's fielded on the back line of the end zone. And they will play it safe here and bring this one out to the 25. The Colts come to the line ready to start their next drive. They control their own destiny here. They have the football in overtime. Obviously, a touchdown would win it.
And I think teams around the league are still adjusting to the idea of going downfield, scoring a touchdown wins the game, because they were used to just going downfield and trying to get in field goal range to win a game. Still having to make that transition. Let's face it now. The ones who are doing it best know they need to go down, attack, put the ball in the end zone, and not leave it up to a field goal and give the other team a chance.
As we said, they control their own destiny now. Back to Taylor on first down. And the reinforcements come in as they're going to stop him behind the line. Officially, it's a 1-yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11.
Loss of a yard brings up second and 11 at the 37-yard line.
On second down now, it's Taylor. And they will only muster a yard here to the 38. Only a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a third down.
Typically, we think it's the strong safeties that are better tacklers, especially closer to the line of scrimmage amidst traffic. But in this case, how about the free safety coming up and making the big-time play?
Here comes the first throw in OT for Prescott. And he's got the completion to Hopkins. And he is going to have a Colts first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. His first catch, and it's a big one in overtime. It's a first down. Taylor. And maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line. He'll lose a yard there, and it's second and 11. He's had some big runs in this game. Not there, though.
But I don't think they're going to be deterred by that play right there. He's had some nice runs in the game. And how many times have we seen a good running back get stopped, yet turn it into something big on a later carry? I'd stay with him.
2 minutes left in this overtime session, and still all tied. Open man here is Foster, and he'll be taken down by the face mask, it appeared. And yes, out come the flags. In overtime, you have to be smarter than that.
A personal foul just can't happen. Have to have poise.
So now factoring in the face mask, here's first and 10. On the counter, it's Taylor. And this time they were waiting for him as he'll be knocked down before he can get back to the line of scrimmage. They'll wind up losing 3 yards here. And it'll bring up a second and 13. To throw is Prescott. This is caught. And he takes this one in for a Colts touchdown.
Touchdown, Indianapolis.
A partner, great game that we got to see and making it extra special. Not only did I get four quarters with you in this one, I got some overtime, a little whipped cream on top.
Look at you, trying to make this whole thing palatable.
I just want you to pay for my meal later.
You really just wanted four quarters, what you wanted. But how much fun was that? We had that type of a game where we got us to overtime, and then we get the dramatic ending to finish things off as well. What a game.
So for Indianapolis, it's an important win for their playoff hopes as they move to 8-4. And they'll...
Someone put me out cause I'm on fire. I can't give up about what they say. They've been searching for that thing to get them higher. You can't catch my drip, can't catch my wave.
Damn, Kane, you done kill Abel. Unbalanced land, trying to keep the people stable. The way I feel, I might it all up. The way you feel, you might do it for the buck. All black, born to be a rebel. After this, I might go and water down the devil. Listen to everything around me, I can't see. Picked a dozen roses and left them in Galilee rolling thunder. Don't hear my cry, don't let alibis pass you by. Finally starting to realize, never give up and coincide. Can't watch TV, it's all a lot, tired of trying. Go ahead and fly, everybody want a straight answer. But media keep us blind. A good heart is not hard to find. Why do people try to define infrastructure? Right, black time infrastructure, right, I'm black time. We're talking about you, brought to protecting the sons and daughters from political mislaughter.
Someone put me out cause I'm on fire. I can't give up about what they say. They've been searching for that thing to get the fire. You can't catch my drift, can't catch my wave.
Never play by the rules, that's I'm paying my dues. They gon' try to intrude, poison the multitude. They be quick to accuse, when you got different views. Just know you gon' pay the price, best off the item you choose. Many ties in the culture, hit you with MK Ultra. I knew you was a vulture, Holy Ghost get the ushers. No, I can't trust you, shock you, deny you, fluster. Crashing down, I was cluttered, doing this so subtle. Falling out through the rubble, remember this in jungle. The top, I was gonna get something, the middle gotta stay hunting. Why the rush up for nothing, why the rush up for nothing?